Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to the Craft Time Studio. I'm Ange, your weekend crafter, and just like I promised, I'm going to make a simple slab using the modern retro colors that I mixed last week. If you haven't seen that yet, I'm placing a link above so that you can check it out. Color mixing usually inspires me to create, which is why I love doing it so often. For this particular slab, I wanted to do something a little bit boho. I love the Bohemian style because it gives you an opportunity to experiment with vibrant colors, patterns, and layers. I went ahead and flattened out a light tan color into the number 4 setting on my ruler. You will also need a square cutter and a tissue blade. A detail needle will also come in handy. So to get myself organized, I rolled out all my different retro colors into the number 7 setting. With a repeating pattern like this, it helps to get all your colors organized. Then, I positioned my square to make a diamond pattern and pressed it down. I moved up about an eighth of an inch, pressed my cutter down again, and then moved up a third time and pressed down my cutter. You will know that you got the right shape when you see a smaller diamond at the center. I repeated this for all the colors, and then I peeled off all the excess clay. Then, I gently pushed my tissue blade underneath to loosen the parts. So essentially, you'll pick on each part and lay them down on the main slab. I decided that I wanted to go the other way with the next color, and so I started putting the pieces from the top to the bottom. You can also use alternating colors, but for this lab in particular, I wanted to use all the colors that I have. I repeated these steps until the entire slab was covered. Once I am happy with the placement of the shapes, I get some parchment paper and a plastic roller to roll all the shapes in place. I come back with my blade and put horizontal lines on some parts. I also used my detail needle to put dots along the shapes. And so here is my final product, a very simple slab with a bit of a tribal or boho element to it. To make them into earrings, I used a circular cutter, a teardrop shaped cutter, and a hole cutter to make the holes on the earrings. And there you have it. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I always love sharing what I've made for the week, be it a color recipe or my newest lab. If you haven't yet, do consider liking and subscribing to the Craft Time Studio. Have a crafty week ahead. Bye!